Hello everyone, I am Dr. Sirajul Akfaizi. In my YouTube channel, today in this video, I am going to talk about computational chemistry. Computational chemistry is very important branch of chemistry nowadays. So I will light on importance of computational chemistry in present scenario among the researcher, faculties and in academia. So let us start with the definitions. You know, the computational chemistry uses results of theoretical chemistry. Now you will ask, what is theoretical chemistry? You have learned physical chemistry. So incorporated into efficient computer programs to calculate structure and properties of molecules. It calculates the properties of molecules such as structure, relative inertia, charge distribution, dipole moment, vibrational frequency, reactivity, and other spectroscopic quantity. You know, my friend, computational chemistry range from highly accurate ab initio method to less accurate semi-empirical, very approximate molecular mechanics. So what is the advantages or advantage of computational chemistry? It allows the medicinal chemist for use the computational power of computer for measurement of molecular geometry, electron density, electrostatic potential, conformational analysis, different types of energies, determination of structure of ligand and target through X-ray crystallography and NMR spectroscopy. So docking of ligand, you know the docking process. Docking of ligand in receptor active sites and exact measurement of geometric and energetic fever ability of such interactions. Comparison of various ligands through various parameters. So what does computational chemistry calculate? This is our question. What does computational chemistry calculate? Why we are much interested in computational chemistry? Energy, structure and properties. The answer of this question. What is the energy for a given geometry? How does energy vary when geometry change? Which geometries are stable? How do atoms rearrange to form new molecules, and how do structure, energy and properties change over time? So what does computational chemistry calculate? Examples: ionization energy, homo energy, electron affinity, LUMO energy, proton affinity, electronic excitation energy, UV visible spectroscopy, NMR, chemical shift and coupling constant, reaction path and barrier height, and reaction rate. Reaction path and barrier height and reaction rate. So molecular modeling methods. What is the modeling? The three-dimensional shape of both ligand and target site may be determined by X-ray crystallography or computational method. The most common computational methods are based on either molecular or quantum mechanics. Both these approaches produce equation for total energy of the structure. So there are two main types methods depending on the starting point theory: classical method and quantum chemistry method. In classical method are those methods use neutron mechanics to model molecular system. In quantum chemistry method, which makes use of quantum mechanics to model the molecular system, and this method use different types of approximation to solve Schrödinger equations. So classical method, molecular mechanics and molecular dynamics. You know the quantum mechanics methods, semi-empirical methods, ab initio methods, and density functional methods. So look at here, computational chemistry, quantum mechanics, QM, molecular mechanics, MM, hybrid quantum mechanics and molecular mechanics, and semi-empirical. So molecular mechanics program use equations based on classical physics to calculate force field. Atoms treated as a sphere, bond as a spring, and electron are ignored. It is assumed that the total potential energy of molecule is given by sum of all energies of attractive and repulsive forces between atom in structure. So the molecular mechanics equations you can see, E is equal to Eb, Aa, Ed, and Enb. What does it mean? The energy involved in the deformation bond, either by the stretching or compression, the energy involved in the angle bending and torsional angular energy, the energy involved in the interaction between atoms and that are not directly bonded. Look at here, torsional angular bond stretching, angle bending, and non-bonded interactions. So what is the meaning of force field? Force field refer to calculations of interaction energy between different atom between bonds, stretching, angle bending, torsion angles, and non-bonding interaction. Force field ignore the electronic distribution while the quantum mechanics consider electronic distribution of molecules. So classical empirical force field like AMBER full form is assisted model building and energy refinement. Graham's chemistry at Harvard, macromolecular mechanics, and CVFF consistence valence force field. So molecular model using molecular mechanics. The molecular models are created by either using an existing potential force field computer program or assembling a model from a structural fragment held in the database of molecular modeling program. You know, and you can see the water, benzene, ammonia, methanol, and methane. You will have this type of density structure. Now you have the second stage, you can combine together. Then the force field of the model to minimize to give the final structure, you can see here. So an outline of the steps involved using inside it second to produce a stick model of the structure of the parameter. So molecular dynamics. Molecular dynamics is a molecular mechanics program designed to mimic the moment of atom within a molecule. So molecular dynamics can be carried out or a molecules to generate different conformation which on energy minimization give range of a stable conformation. Alternative bonds can be rotated in a stepwise process to generate different conformation. Molecular dynamics can also be used to find minimum energy structure and conformational analysis. So look at here, energy versus time, butane, you can see the degree of rotation versus energy. You will get the eclipse, skew or gauge, staggered. So plot of change in the energy with the rotation about C2-C3 bond in butane, and other bond you have to freeze it. Now quantum mechanics. Quantum mechanics is based on rearrangement of electrons of molecules, interaction of those electrons with electrons and nuclei of other molecules. It based on the realization that electron in all materials exhibit wave-like properties. You know the quantum mechanics based on finding solution to Schrödinger wave equation. So Schrödinger equation, you know, and you have learned in the previous classes, the Schrödinger equation is the basis of quantum mechanics and give a complete descriptions of the electronic structure of molecules. If the equation could be fully solved, all information of molecules could be determined. Si is equal to E psi, where H Hamiltonian operator, psi wave function, E energy system. You know, to solve the Schrödinger equation was found too difficult. Hydrogen, total energy of hydrogen can be described as the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy of its two components, that is proton and electron. So Schrödinger equation for this relationship can be written as Si is equal to K plus V is equal to E psi, where K kinetic energy and V potential energy. We know all. Describe both the wave and particle behavior of electrons. You know from the previous theory, the wave functions is described by psi while the particle behavior is represented by E. In the system with more than one electron, the wave function is dependent on the position of atom. This makes it important to have an accurate geometric description of a system. So, quantum mechanics methods, ab initio methods, semi-empirical method, and density function theory. So, ab initio translated from Latin means from first principle. This refers to the fact that no experimental data is used and computations are based on quantum mechanics. It derived directly from the theoretical principle. So, different level of ab initio calculation, Hartree-Fock and density function theory. So, what is Hartree-Fock? The simplest ab initio calculation, it is based on central field approximation. The major disadvantage of Hartree-Fock calculation is that electron correlation is not taken into consideration. So, density function theory, you know, the considered an ab initio method, but different from other ab initio method because the wave function is not used to describe molecule. Density function theory, in which total energy is expressed in term of total electron density, is used. DFT method take less computational time than HF Hartree-Fock calculations and are considered more accurate. So, semi-empirical quantum methods represent a middle road between the mostly qualitative results available from molecular mechanics and the high computational time and quantity results from ab initio method. So, semi-empirical method use experimental data to parameterize equation. Like ab initio method, Hamiltonian and wave functions are used. So less accurate than ab initio method, but also much faster, capable of calculating translation state and excited state. So choice of methods. The method of calculations based on what calculation need to be done and size of molecules. Molecular mechanics useful for energy minimization, identifying a stable conformation, energy calculation for a specific conformation, studying molecular motion, studying different conformations. So, quantum mechanics method are suitable for calculating molecular orbital energy, heat formation for a specific conformation, dipole moment, bond dissociation energy, and transition state geometries and energy. So, computational cost versus accuracy. You can see the accuracy, quantum mechanical methods, molecular mechanics, atom in small molecules, large compounds, and nano cluster, protein, DNA, and RNA, and number of atoms. Now, quantum mechanics versus molecular mechanics. Quantum mechanics correctly describe the bond breaking and bond forming. Application limited to hundreds of atoms. Does not properly describe the bond breaking and bond forming. Can treat more than 10,000 atoms. Now, quantum mechanics and molecular mechanics more, you know, the more expensive, less expensive. More time, less time. More computing power, less computing power. Used for small molecules, used for large molecules. It calculate electronic property like electron density. It cannot calculate electronic properties like electron density. Application limited to 100 of atom and application to more than 10,000 of atom. So these are the differences between quantum mechanics and molecular mechanics. So energy minimization, what does it mean? Energy minimization produces the nearest stable conformation to the structure represented and not necessarily the global conformation. Energy minimization involves alterations of bond length, bond angle, torsion angles, and non-bonded interactions. So you can see the E total for different value of parameter of the model structure. Starting conformation, the change in the E total, the global minimum energy value for E total, the local minimum energy value for E total, change in parameter value. So, molecular mechanics energy minimization. Molecular mechanics is an approach of energy minimization that find a stable low energy conformation by changing the geometry of the structure. Types of algorithm, steepest descent procedures, conjugated gradient procedure, Newton-Raphson's procedure. So, selection of energy minimization algorithms. The selection of energy minimization algorithm depends on size of system and current state of optimization. when molecules having larger than 200 atom, then conjugated gradient procedure. When molecules having less than 200 atom, then Newton's-Raphson procedure. When molecule having larger than 10 kilocalorie per mole, then the steepest descent. So computer graphics, how you use computer graphics? In molecular modeling, data produced are converted as visual image on a computer. Image displayed as a space field model, ball and stick model, CPK model, mesh model, ribbon model. So look at here, stick model, ball and stick model, CPK model, and mesh representation of aspirin and ribbon representation of dihydrofolate reductase. So my friends, I hope this video will be helpful to you. If you like this video, then subscribe my channel, and thanks for watching.